Okay, thank you. Let's begin. My name is Robin Harding. I'm the Tokyo Bureau Chief for the Financial Times. And it's my pleasure to host this press conference today on the urgent issue of the move of the potential move of the Tokyo Olympic Marathon from the city of Tokyo to Sapporo. Obviously, this has provoked a lot of controversy, a lot of interest from the foreign media. We've called this press conference a very short notice, so thank you to those who have turned out today, and I'm sure many others will be watching the live video stream. It's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Hiroshi Yamada and Mr. Taro Shirato, both members of the Tokyo Assembly for the Tomin First Party, to talk about this issue today. They will speak for around 30 to 40 minutes, and then we will move to question and answers. So without further ado, let me hand over to our speakers today, Mr. Yamada and Mr. Shirato. These gentlemen.
Hi, good morning. Thank you very much for taking time today, and my sincere apologies for this very, very short notice. We are a member of the Tokyo Metropolitan Assembly, and we are the largest party in Tokyo Metropolitan Assembly, 50 from 127. And my name is Hiroshi Yamada. I'm a member of the Tokyo Metropolitan Assembly and also attorney at law in Japan and New York City. I'm the head of this project team. And today, I'd like to explain our view about the sudden announcement of the IOC to move the marathon and race walking from Sapporo to Tokyo. We think its process is extremely unfair. Besides, we think they should be held in Tokyo. And we think this IOC's announcement poses a serious, significant question about the sustainability of the Olympics. So this is our view, but Mr. Shirato Taro is here.
Hi, I'm Taro Shirato, Tokyo Metropolitan Assembly members for Tomin First. I used to be a professional triathlete 20 years, and I was organizing some sports event. Then, speak from the perspective of the athlete today.
Okay, それではですね、I'm sorry, I'd like to need help of the interpreter here. ではですね、すいません、ここからですね、日本語で通訳のですね、サポートを得ながら進めさせていただきたいと思います。お手元にですね、資料3点ございますでしょうか。
Do you have the three sets of materials in front of you? Three sets of materials.
ワンセットはこのワードの縦書きのものでございます。
The first set should be the words document, which is long, which is oblong.
こちらに基づいて基本的には話させていただきます。
And this will be the basis of my presentation today.
あと2点はですね、我々が先週記者会見都庁の方でさせていただいた時のですね、英訳の資料がもう1点でございます。
And the other side of document actually is the English version of the document which we based our press conference last week.
そしてもう1点、こちらも急遽なんですけど、お手元にございますでしょうか。
And also the third set of document was prepared quite, quite a short notice. I hope you have this third document as well.
IOC のコーツさんがですね、先週小池都知事と会われたときにお持ちになった資料です。
This third document is the document which was used by Chairman Coates when he met Governor Koike at Tokyo Metropolitan Government Office last week.
それではですね、こちらのレジュメに沿って簡単に私から説明させていただきます。
So a brief comment based on this outline of the document.
でまず1番、今回のですね、時系列でございます。
First is the time sequence.
東京はですね、2013年にオリンピックのですね、当然マラソンと競歩を含んだですね、招致が決まって以来、着実に準備進めてまいりました。
Tokyo has been making steadfast preparations to hold a marathon and race walking in Tokyo ever since the bid decision has been reached since 2013.
そしてですね、9月15日にはテストイベントの MGC マラソングランドチャンピオンシップもですね実施いたしまして、その後ですね、ドーハの、今回問題になりました女子マラソンもありましたが、そのイベントの後もですね、IOC のバッハ会長はですね、東京のこれまでの取り組み、大変高く評価していただいています。
And in September, we had the test event in, for the Tokyo Olympic Games, namely the Marathon Grand Championship, or MGC, and subsequently the Doha Women's Marathon, which became the point of discussion, was held. But even after that Doha Women's Marathon, Dr. Bach, the president of IOC, said that he highly appreciated Tokyo's measures against, in terms of this marathon.
ただその後ですね、何がどう決まって起こったのか我々も把握はしていないんですけれども、16日にですね、コーツさん、明日から行われる IOC のですね、調整委員会の会長ですけれども、小池都知事に電話で今回の件を伝えたとされております。時間はすみません、正確ではありませんが。
But after comment in which Mr. Bach highly appreciated Tokyo's preparations, we're not sure what happened in between. But on October 16th, Mr. John Coates, who is the chairman of the IOC Coordination Committee, who will be chairing the meeting this week in Tokyo, he called Governor Yuriko Koike on the phone. We're not sure the exact timing, but he called her on the phone.
驚くことにですね、本当にその後ですね、IOC が対外的に、今回の件を発表するんですけども、その同じ日であったと。で、その後にですね、もうこれはすでに決定した事項であるというふうにですね、バッハ会長もおっしゃられていると。
And surprisingly, this call was made on the very day in which IOC made the announcement about this particular decision. And furthermore, President Bach said that the move was already a decided matter. It was already decided.
そして先週ですね、コーツ25日、コーツ調整委員会委員長もいらっしゃいまして、小池知事と面会されましたけれども、そこでも本件はもうすでに決定事項であると改めて強調されていらっしゃる。
And on October 25th, Chairman Coates met Governor Koike in person. And on that occasion, once again, he emphasized that this matter was already decided.
明日の30日からですね、IOC であったり、またオーガナイズングコミッティ、組織委員会、そして東京都等などのですね、ステークホルダーで議論がされる、調整委員会の場で議論がされるものである。そこで調整がされるものだと認識なんですけれども、決定だ決定だということがですね繰り返しおっしゃられていると。
It is our understanding, that at the IOC Coordination Committee meeting, which will start from tomorrow, this matter will be addressed between the various stakeholders, such as the IOC Organizing Committee, the Tokyo Metropolitan Government, and other stakeholders. It is a matter that we believe will be addressed and discussed at this forum. However, the IOC keeps insisting that this matter is already decided.
以上述べてきたようにですね、ここで2番に、レジュメの2番ですけれども、そもそも事前にミスター・コーツがですね、小池知事に電話してきたのも、プレスリリースの日の当日だったこと、そしてドーハマラソンの後ですら、大変バッハ会長ですね、東京の取り組み、評価していただいていた、また調整委員会があるにもかかわらずですね、もうすでに決定事項であると繰り返す、こういったことに対して、我々この手続きに対してですね、非常に問題があると。いうふうに考えております。
And going on to number two, in terms of this overall process, as is already clear from these events, the phone call from Mr. Coates was on the very day that this press release was disclosed. And also, we would like to further add that even after the Doha Women's Marathon, President Bach continued to appreciate Tokyo's efforts. And also, and furthermore, although there is the coordination committee coming up.The IOC is repeatedly insisting that this matter is already decided, and we believe that there are various issues and problems pertaining to this overall process on hand.
はい、ではですね、すみません、レジュメの次のページ3番をお願いいたします。
You could turn over the page and go on to the other, the next item on this resume.
私たちは手続きの他にもですね、IOC の提案を真摯に検討いたしました。その結果ですね、やはり東京でマラソン競歩がですね。開催されるべきであると考えております。
And on top of these questions pertaining to the process, we received the proposal, if you will, from the IOC very sincerely and gave it the maximum thought. And after a very after thorough scrutiny on our part, we still feel that the marathon and the race walking event should be held here in Tokyo.
こちらのですね、プレゼンテーションの資料のすみません、3ページと4ページをですね、ご覧いただきたいんですけれども。
May we ask you to turn to the presentation materials, pages 3 and 4, please.
IOC はですね、日本、ドーハと東京がですね、同じような非常に似た状況であるというふうなですね、ご主張されておりますが、我々はそのようには考えておりません。
The IOC is insisting that the situation pertaining to Doha and Tokyo are similar. We do not believe that is the case.
詳しくはこちらの資料の3ページと4ページをご覧いただければと思うんですけれども、ドーハはですね、日本の環境省の出しているこの4ページの基準に照らしてですね、レースのスタートから終わりまで常に厳重警戒のレベルであったと。
As for the details, we hope that you'll take a look at these pages, pages 3 and 4, at your leisure later on. However, it seems that, but based on the materials and the guidelines provided by the Ministry of Environment, you will find that the circumstances pertaining to the Doha Marathon indicated a severe warning, if you will, a very severe warning from the start of the marathon until the end of the marathon.
加えてですね、我々独自に考えて、まず東京都の正式な提案ではないんですけども、我々としましては、例えば朝5時にですね、今6時ですが、5時に開始とすればですね、ドーハとは異なる問題がないですね、シビアウォーニング状況にならないですね、天候、気候の状況を保てるというふうに考えています。
Now, the following is not an official proposal from the Tokyo Metropolitan Government, but after having conducted various thoughts and consideration on our part, we were able to identify that if we could start the marathon at 5 a.m., then we will not face the issues like the ones we faced in Doha, and that we will not have to face the level of severe warning in the case of Tokyo Marathon if the start time was brought forward to 5 a.m.
この5時のようにですね、開始時間を早めるという提案に対してですね、先週コーツ、ミスターコーツはですね、否定的のように見えました。その一つの理由として、メディアのヘリコプターがですね、なかなか夜飛べないのではないかと、そういった懸念が示されております。
Now, against our proposal of changing the starting time to 5 a.m., it seems that Mr. Coates has shown a fairly negative response. And it seems that he's indicating that if it is brought forward to 5 a.m., then it would be difficult for the media helicopters to fly at night. That seems to be the concern on their part.
こちらの資料の5ページにですね、写真があるんですが、東京大体5時少し前がですね、夜明け、日の出でございますので、そのご懸念は当たらないと。思います。加えてですね、アスリートファーストというのであればですね、メディアのヘリコプターのことを理由にされるのはおかしいのではないかと考えています。
And if you can turn to page 5 of the other presentation material, this shows you the pictures from Tokyo. And you'll find that in Tokyo, the sunrise is slightly before 5 a.m. And so therefore, the concerns, the so-called concerns over the media and the helicopter pictures is not valid, as is clear from this picture. And also, if we are placing athletes first, then should we prioritize the concern about media helicopters ahead of the athletes?
こちらの IOC の資料のですね、5ページにですね、ドーハと東京が似ていると、類似しているという根拠が示されているようなんですけれども、なかなかこれ、じゃあ時間はどうなのかとはですね、詳細がですね、明らかになっておりませんでして、必ずしも十分ではないというふうに考えておるところです。今のは IOC の資料の方です。
And in the third material, which we provided to you, which is the IOC material, which is material on page 5, they are providing grounds based on which they believe that the situation in Doha will be close as to the situation in Tokyo. We believe that this information is quite insufficient in that there are lack of details and also lack of details about the timeline and so forth. So we believe that that will not be sufficient basis.
そしてですね、IOC が理由とされているアスリートファーストですけれども、暑さだけではないと思っております。この点について後で白戸議員から詳細ご説明ありますけれども、暑さ以外にもですね、これまで準備してきたアスリートの再調整であったり、またテロをはじめとするとですね、さまざまな安全対策、また本当に札幌で実現できるのか、雪が降る札幌でですね、さまざまな課題もあるというようなところを指摘させていただきますが、詳しくはですね、こちらの資料の6ページと、後で白戸議員からまた説明させていただきます。
And also, what does it mean when we say athlete first? It's not just about heat. We believe that there are other factors as well, based on which Mr. Shirato will be speaking later on. But there are other factors outside the heat. Also, the possible burden in terms of the reconditioning for the athletes, and also anti-terrorism measures for which we have already made various preparations. And so there, and also, there is likely to be potential issues pertaining to support actually holding the events. And so as far as the details are concerned, please take a look at the pages of page six and onwards, and also Mr. Shirato will be talking about the details later on.
このようにですね、我々はやはり東京で開催すべきだと思っているんですけれども、もし万が一にですね、札幌でやる場合にはですね、多額のですね、コストの問題が出てくると考えています。
So that being the case, we are of the view and of the position that these events should be held here in Tokyo. But in the event that these events are changed to a different venue, and then issues pertaining to cost will also emerge.
その試算の結果がですね、こちらの我々の資料の7ページ以下に詳細を記載しております。
And the approximate cost calculation which we have carried out is indicated on page 7 of our material.
本来これはですね、我々ではなくて組織委員会がすべきものなんですけれども、残念ながら組織委員会の方ではですね、こういったものを調整委員会、明日からの調整委員会の前にですね、提出はされないような動向でございますので、問題提起の意味でですね、我々から合理的に可能な範囲で必要な情報から算定したものでございます。
Ordinarily, this type of cost approximation should be provided by the organizing committee, but it seems that there is a very low likelihood of the organizing committee providing such information in advance of the coordination committee meeting which will be held. So therefore, that being the case, we try to compile our own cost approximation to the best of our abilities based on information which were available to us.
その結果ですね、もし札幌で開催する場合にはですね、340億円以上かかるのではないか、また10ページではですね、ではこれまでじゃあ東京であったり、東京都民がですね、被った損害についてもですね、これも本当に荒いものではございますが、数百億円にもありうるというようにですね、考えているところでございます。
And based on such calculation, we anticipate that the approximate cost of holding the events in Sapporo could actually exceed 34 billion yen. And also, when you take a look at our material, page 10, we have also carried out the calculation of possible damages for the people of Tokyo should these events be moved. And as you can see on page 10, the potential damages could range in tens of billions of yen.
ではですね、このワードのレジュメの最後のですね、3ページ目のですね、5番になるんですけれども、まあ、東京開催、今回の問題はですね、本当に今後のですね、オリンピックのですね、持続可能性にも大きな問題をもたらすものだと考えておりまして、この点についてもですね、私はもう間もなく終わりますので、白戸議員から合わせて説明いただきたいと思います。
And I come to the final point of my outline, which is number 5. I believe this particular issue really goes to the potential sustainability of the Olympic Games. In other words, are these games truly sustainable? On this point, we would like to raise this issue for your consideration. And also, I would like to call upon my colleague, Mr. Shirato, to talk about this.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Tokyo is facing serious problem right now regarding the Olympic Games. We think we need to share this with the world because this is not only our problem. If we let IOC do this, I might ruin the sustainability of Olympic Games. Sorry, but I will speak in Japanese from now.
今回の問題に関しましてはですね、まず選手、そして競技関係者、まあ、東京都の皆さん、そして地元の皆さんが、まあ、どれだけここまで準備してきたのかを全く理解してもらっていないかということに、非常に憤りを感じております。
Yeah, thank you very much. As far as this particular issue is concerned, I really have a very strong sense of anger and frustration about the fact that people just simply do not understand how much preparation has been put in by the athletes and by the community.By the various federations and also Tokyo Metropolitan Government as well as the members of the local community.
まあ決定してから6年経っています。そして6回の夏が過ぎました。どうして6回過ぎた後なのか、この大会までの直前の時期なのか、まあここまで検証して確認してきたということではなかったんでしょうか。
But it's been 6 years since that decision was made.We have gone through 6 summers since that decision, but immediately prior to the games, this decision has been put forward. Haven't sufficient verification, scrutiny, and confirmation been carried out up until now?
まあ、アスリートにももちろんですが、まあ、チケットを買って、楽しみにしていた感染者、そして沿道で、まあ、唯一観戦できる観戦の皆さん、そして運営の皆さん、まあ、こういった方々に配慮が足りない、まさにこれは、アスリートファーストという言葉を使ってますが、どう見てもこう IOC ファーストではないかと感じてしまいます。
And this, that being the case, you get the sense that no consideration has been made in relation to the athletes, the spectators who had already bought tickets and who were looking forward to these events, and also the potential spectators who would have been cheering on the streets, and also to the members of the people involved in the operations. No consideration has been made on these people. And although they talk about so-called athlete first, from where we sit, it can only be perceived as IOC first.
まあ、運営の方々はですね、計測、セキュリティ、ボランティア、まあ、競技運営など丁寧な準備を重ねてきました、まあ、その成功の形が今年の9月に東京で行われました MGC、マラソングランプリチャンピオンシップだと思いますし、まあ、出場した選手たち、関係者たちも非常にこの大会の運営を評価していました。
So people involved in the operations have carried out meticulous, very careful preparations in terms of the measurement of the course, security, volunteers, and also in terms of the actual venue and the competition operations. And we believe that the success of their preparation was embodied in the MGC, the marathon championship, which was held in Tokyo in September. Not only the athletes, but all the people involved in these events highly praised the MGC.
まあ、実は IOC はですね、まあ、コーツさんがドーハの大会を見てるんですけども、この MGC 見てないんですよね。つまり MGC を見たら、日本の大会、日本の暑さ対策、日本の運営対策を見てないで、ドーハと比較をしている、ここに問題があると思います。
Now, Chairman Coates, he observed the marathon event in Doha. However, he was not present in the MGC marathon in Tokyo. And so the issue is that they're making comparison between Doha and Tokyo without having observed how the events were operated here in Tokyo. We believe that represents an issue.
まあ、ドーハは、まあ BBC なんかでもね、運営があまり良くなかったというようなことは言われてますが、まあ、それはさておきまして、まあ、日本の実際行ったチームの関係者からは、まあ、倒れた選手、関係者、チームだとか選手にはですね、この暑さに対しての準備が全く足りてなかったんじゃないか、通常、あ、ごめん。
Now, it's been, according to some sources, it's been said that the overall operations of the event in Doha were not very meticulous. And some of the members of the Japanese teams did indicate that there were the athletes and teams who did collapse on the course. But we cannot negate the fact that perhaps there was a shortfall of preparations on their part.
まあ、通常ですね、このような暑い大会の時は、アイススラリーって皆さんお分かりになるか分かりません、氷水みたいなものですね、それとか氷を握ったりとかさせてですね、まあ、普通こういう暑さ対策をしてくる、これはもう普通、今はもう当たり前の話なんですが、実際こういうことを全くしてなかった、あの倒れた選手たちは、まあ、エイドステーションでもスペシャルでも、結局、真水の普通の常温の水を出していた、まあ、はたから見ていても、これ大丈夫というような、そんな状態だったそうです。
We're not sure whether or not you're familiar with the so-called ice slurries, but these are actually a cold ice and water, which would actually be provided to athletes in events of such heat. However, in Doha, in the aid stations, in the medical care first aid stations, all those athletes collapsed and they were brought to those aid stations. They simply provided not ordinary temperature water, not cool temperature. And even to a casual observer, one has to question, was this a viable operation to begin with?
マラソンというのは、ある意味非常に過酷なスポーツです。そして過酷なスポーツゆえに、たとえ気温が25度でも6度でも準備不足では非常に危険です。逆にしっかりと準備さえしていれば30度を超えても問題がない。これは過去の世界選手権でもアジア大会でも見ていただけると証明されていると思います。
The marathon sport is a very rigorous, very, very rigorous sport. And so, if there's lack of preparation on the part of the athletes, then even at the temperature of 25 or 26 degrees, the sport could be very dangerous and risky. However, as long as you're fully prepared, then you will not face any problems, even if the temperature were to exceed 30 degrees. And I believe that has already been verified and confirmed in past games, such as the World Championships and the Asian Games.
まあ、選手はそう言うとですね、選手は声を上げてないんじゃないかとよく言われるんですが、まあ、選手はやはり、今社会的な背景を考えると余計なことを口出しできないという、まあ、日本、まあ、アジアなのかもしれません、いわゆる忖度をしなければいけない状況にあるから今声を出してないだけなんですね。
Now, of course, there are some people who say that the athletes haven't said anything about this decision.That may be the case. However, considering the background and the context, and perhaps this is very Japanese and Asian way, but they really have to be very careful about their own position, and also they have to take into consideration the position of the others. And that is the only reason why they have not been vocal up until now.
それは選手たちはですね、まあ、MGC も含めてここまで周到に長年かけて1年以上かけてこの MGC の前もですね、暑さの対策を進めてきました。そしてその成果があの MGC の素晴らしいレースになったというところだと思います。まあ、選手たちもそれが発揮できない、今までそれをやってきたことが発揮できないことが一番悔しいと選手たちは言っておりました。
And these athletes have actually prepared a very long time, at least up until a year, for this MGC race and also for these events. And they have taken sufficient countermeasures in between. And the outcome of those preparations have manifested into the success of the MGC race. And the athletes, they have all pointed out that the most frustrating thing and the most vexing thing for them is that they're not able to demonstrate those preparations.
選手が言ってました、東京はこれだけ準備をして、まあ、テストした MGC ですね、テストイベントを重ねてきたからこそ安心して思いっきり走れると。準備不足の場所で開催する不安、そしてそのレースを走る不安っていうのが、非常に、懸念されると。これは選手の言葉です。
And the following are the words which I have heard from the athletes.The athletes feel that they can actually run the event without any anxiety and with a sense of peace of mind because they know that Tokyo has made sufficient preparations and that they have continued to accumulate preparations for the MGC event. However, the athletes also say that they're very concerned about and anxious about having to do a race in a place where there could potentially be shortfall of preparations.
まあ、つまりリスクは暑さ以外にもたくさんあるんですよ。例えばセーフティー、メディカル、オーガナイジング、アコモデーション、プレパレーションアスリート、さまざまなリスクがある。決して暑さというのはそのリスクの中のほんの一つのファクターでしかないですね。
In other words, there are other potential risks aside from the heat. For example, operations, safety, accommodation, and the preparation of the athletes. In other words, among the potential risks, heat is only one of the many factors.
まあ、そして先ほど示した通り、暑さは早朝にスタートすれば全く問題がないということも分かっています。
And as we have already indicated earlier, in terms of the question of the heat, as long as the starting time is early, then that does not present any problems.
ちなみに海外のチームからはですね、直 直前キャンプ、東京オリンピックゲームの前の直前のキャンプの場所を決めて最後のプレパレーションの計画をしているんですが、まあ、このキャンプ地の計画ができないということで非常に困っているというメールをいただいています。
And by the way, for your reference, I've received an email from one of the overseas teams for these events, and they were saying that they were very perplexed because although they have to carry out a camp prior to the actual events, they are not able to plan for those training camps before.
我々が考えますこの真のアスリートファーストというのは十分に時間をかけて準備された大会のコースで、まあ、そのコースに対、そのコースの大会に対する十分な準備期間を取っておくこと、これこそがアスリートファーストではないかと考えます。
So as far as we believe that the athlete first concept in the truest sense is that the athletes are able to take sufficient time for preparations in relation to the course of the games and take sufficient time to also be able to take sufficient preparations on that course. We believe this represents the true athlete first.
もう一つの視点としては、やはりもうそろそろサスティナブルなオリンピックを考えた方がいいんではないかということです。まあ、このままでは夏のオリンピックはもう開催できる場所はなくなってしまう。今度のフランスはどうしますか。42度です夏は。パリオリンピックはリールでやるんですか、彼でやるんですかという話です。そろそろ IOC のこのスタンスを考えないとオリンピックの未来はないというふうに考えます。
Correction from the interpreter. True athlete first means that the athletes being able to take sufficient time for preparations in a course for which sufficient time was provided for preparation purposes. The other thing is that the Olympic Games has to be sustainable. Going forward, if this situation were to continue, then there would be very few cities that can host the Summer Olympic Games going forward. What about France? It was 42 degrees in summer. Are you going to host the games in cities like Lille or Calais?Unless the IOC scrutinizes and revisits this position, we believe that there is no future for the Olympic Games.
まあ今回の札幌、東京という話ではなくて、やはりこう将来のオリンピック像というのを考えていくときに来ているのかなというふうに考えます。
So we believe that this isn't just an issue between for Tokyo and Sapporo. We believe we are now at a juncture where we really have to give thought to the future of the Olympic Games going forward.
最後にもう一つだけ、いろいろ私今回の問題でアスリートにインタビューをしてきました。関係者にもインタビューをしてきました。
One last thing. On this particular matter, I've had the chance to talk to various athletes as well as stakeholders involved in these events.
彼らが最後に必ず言うのは、あの7万人が入る満員の新国立競技場にゴールするのが夢だと。これを夢見てトレーニングもしてきたし頑張ってきた。それが奪われるのが一番悲しいということを言っていました。
And they all are unanimous in the following. They all said that they had dreamed of going through the goal line in the new national stadium packed with 70,000 spectators. And that was their aspirations. And that was the goal based toward which they have prepared up until now. And for that goal and aspiration to be taken away is the saddest thing. That is what they all said.
そして街の中で行うのがこのマラソンと競歩です。つまり街の景色に溶け込むのはこの種目たちしかないんですね。
And also both the race walking and the marathon events will be held inside the city in the city streets and so there are no other events such as these two that really assimilate into the city environment.
まあこれが観客にはもちろんですが、選手にとっても永遠にこう記憶に残る都市のこのオリンピックの景色になっていくというふうに思います。そして今までこれまでですね、主催都市でマラソンを開催しなかったオリンピックはありません。
And we believe that that image, that view will remain with the spectators as well as with the athletes forever. Also, there has never been a case in the past where the marathon event was not hosted in the host city.
我々は本来の計画通り東京でのマラソン競歩の開催を主張します。
So we would like to stress.That as planned, these events, the race walking and marathon event, be held in Tokyo. This is what we would like to stress.
Thank you for taking time.
Okay, thank you very much for those presentations. I'm going to ask a few questions to start off, mainly confirming some facts, and then move to your questions.
プレゼンテーションありがとうございました。それでは次に入るまで私が何点かちょっと確認のためにご質問させていただいて、その後ご質問をお受けします。
So first, in your understanding, is it the IOC that decided the Olympics must be held in August, which we know is a hot month in Tokyo?
まずですね、皆様の理解では、実際にまだ暑いこの8月においてオリンピックを開催しなければならないと決めたのは IOC 側であるというふうに考えておられるんでしょうか。
基本的に誘致の段階の条件に7月15日から8月31日までの開催が条件になっています。
Yes, in terms of when the bid, when the bid for the Olympics was carried out, one of the conditions which we had to comply was that the games be held between July 15th up until August 31st.
Thank you. And the IOC accepted Tokyo's bid, saying that the marathon would be held in Tokyo at these times.
ありがとうございます。またその時点で IOC はマラソン競技が東京で開催されるという内容を、承諾した、受け入れたということですね、その段階で。
もちろん、東京も、まあ、それで承諾してますし、IOC もだからこそ東京でやることを承諾したというふうに認識しています。
Yes, our understanding that indeed that was the basis of the bid candidature by Tokyo, and we believe that IOC has indeed accepted that.
Thank you. And does the IOC have the right to unilaterally change where an event will be held?
ありがとうございます。また、その会場の変更を一方的に、会場の変更を一方的に決定する権限は IOC にあるんでしょうか？
その点はですね、IOC の方はそういった権限があるというふうにですね、主張しておりますけれども、我々としましてはですね、開催都市の作った立候補ファイルを申請して承諾をもらって決まっているということがございますので、IOC が一方的に決めれるものとは思っておりません。ただ認識の相違はあると思います。
I believe IOC has said that it is the IOC's position that they do indeed have such a right. However, as far as we're concerned, we have submitted our bid through the bid file, and that the bid file was accepted as a result. And so therefore, that being the case, we believe that IOC does not have such a right. And so therefore, there seems to be a difference of views between the two parties on this point.
Thank you. And if the marathon were to be held in Sapporo, who should pay for the cost of that?
ありがとうございます。それでもしもマラソン競技が札幌で開催される暁には、そのコストの負担、そのコストは誰が払うべきだとお考えでしょうか？
まず大前提といたしましては、我々としては東京でされるべきだというふうに考えております。
Well, first of all, the very premise based on which we are here today is that these events should be held here in Tokyo.
ただ仮定の回答になりますけれども、やはり都民としてはですね、納得はいかないということは間違いなく言えると思います。
都民との、
都民と都が払うことが
人の方です。
住んでる方です。
会じゃ
ないですか。
ありがとうございます。Thank you. And but I can only respond in the hypothetical manner. But in the event that indeed is changed to Sapporo, then I believe the citizens of Tokyo will not be convinced if they have to pay this cost.
So does that mean the IOC should pay the cost?
そうすると IOC が払うべきだということでしょうか。
まあ回答は難しいですけれども、東京都が払うべきとは考えてはおりません。
Very difficult to respond, but what I can say is that the Tokyo Metropolitan Government, Tokyo, should not be the one to pay.
Thank you. And then my last question, on the final page of your release, you have a list of damages to Tokyo if the marathon is not held in Tokyo. In this event, should Tokyo consider a lawsuit against the IOC to recover these damages?
ありがとうございます。私からは最後の質問です。このいただきました資料の一番最後10ページにですね、都民、東京都の損害の算定をしておられます。もしも、まあ、こういった損害が発生するということですが、こういった状況になった場合、都としてはやはり IOC に対してこの損害賠償を求めるべく訴訟するというふうにするべきだとお考えでしょうか。
まあ、こちらも非常に難しい質問でございますけれども、法的な整理ですね。法的に整理するとどういうことになるかを踏まえた上で、今後の交渉、折衝はすべきだと考えています。
also very difficult to respond. But I believe that in terms of the discussions and negotiations going forward, we need to clarify the legal context.
But the city should seek to recover its damages.
まあ、じゃあその法的なというのは要するにその都としてもその損害を損害賠償を求めると要するにその損害が発生した場合はその賠償を求めるということで整理させていただいてよろしいんでしょうか。
それは今後ですね、もし仮定に仮定を重ねる話になってしまいますのでなかなかこれ以上回答は難しいと。
It's very difficult for me to say anything beyond this because, again, we're talking about a hypothetical situation based on another hypothetical situation. So it's all very hypothetical at this juncture.
Okay, thank you. I'd like to open to questions from the floor. If you could raise your hand. I know we have many Japanese journalists with us today. So if you want to ask your question in Japanese, that is fine.But please give your name and affiliation before you ask your question.
ではご質問に質疑応答にまいりますけれども、挙手でお願いいたします。日本のジャーナリストの方々もおられますけれども、日本語で結構です。で、お名前とご所属をご質問の前にお願いいたします。
Please, do we have any questions?
ご質問があればどうぞ。
Yes, please.
どうぞ。
If you could come to the microphone.
マイク、そう、すみません、マイクお願いいたします。
ありがとうございました。神戸市に住んでいるジャーナリストの阿波野と申します。スポーツジャーナリストではございません。で、無所属なので、まあ、今回は、なんだっけ。週刊朝日だったかな、ね、書く予定ではおります。一つおっしゃってた MGC ですね、あれが高く評価されているのにということを強調されてたと思いますけれども、MGC が行われたのは9月15日です、8月2日とは全く温度が違います、スタート時間も違いましたけれども、MGC は8時で、今度マラソンやるというのは今のところ6時ですね、でそれを6時に合わせて見たところでも、まあ、気象庁の中見ても、全然温度が違いますね、でその辺はどういうふうにお考えでしょうか、あるいはその暑さに強い選手を選ぶということでしたら、なぜ9月の15日、だいぶ涼しくなってからやったのかということが、私はちょっと疑問に思ってるんですけど、もしお分かりになれば、
はい、
す
み
ません。
Yeah, thank you very much. My name is Sawano, a freelance journalist from Kobe. And this time I will be submitting an article to, I believe, Shuka Asahi, the weekly magazine. And you mentioned that the operations of the MGC marathon was highly appreciated. However, you have to bear in mind that MGC was held on September 15th, but totally different in terms of the temperature between August 2nd. And also, I believe the starting time was different. MGC started at 8 a.m., and marathon, for the time being, is scheduled to start at 6 a.m. So if you compare apple to apple, 6 a.m. to 6 a.m., again, the temperature will be totally different. So what are your thoughts about this? And also, the other is that, if you're going to select athletes that are very, resilient against the heat, then why did you hold the test event?On September 15th, when the temperature is much cooler. Thank you.
はい。じゃあ先に、はい。こちら我々の資料のですね、3ページご覧いただければと思うんですけど。
Could you turn to page 3 of the presentation material, page 3, please?
こちらにですね、MGC の気候条件もですね、整理させていただいております。
We provide information about the MGC. すいません。
大変貴重なですね、ご指摘の通りですね、MGC とですね、東京マラソンのですね、開始時間、時期はですね、違います。それを並べて今、気温を整理しております。
And we appreciate your very valuable insight indeed in terms of the starting time and in terms of in terms of starting time and such. There is a difference between the MGC event.
こちらですね、特に我々のですね、5時スタート提案と MGC 比べるとですね、気温の差1度から2度に収まっていると。
But if you compare, for example, the scenario where the starting time for the marathon has been moved up to 5 a.m., and if you compare that with MGC, you will notice that the difference in temperature is only between 1 to 2 degrees.
ですので、このテストイベントのですね、有効性は否定されるものではないと。
So that being the case, we believe that this should not negate the value of the test event.
よろしいですか。 よく温度のことを言われるんですけども、アスリート別に温度で走ってるわけじゃないんですよね。さっき言ったように温度というのは一つのファクターでしかないんです。
If I may also add, yes, many people point to the temperature, but then athletes are not, the athletes are not just basing themselves on the temperature. The temperature is only one of the many factors which they will consider.
例えば、91年谷口博美さんが勝った世界選手権、東京でやってますけど30度超えてます。32度のバンコクのアジア大会、高橋尚子2時間21分当時の日本記録で走ってます。結局温度の問題じゃないと思います、まずは。
And、for example,back in 1991, in the World Championship, which was held in Tokyo back in 1991, Hiromi Taniguchi won the race. The temperature was 31 degrees at the time. And also, in very hot Bangkok, Ms. Takahashi, she posted a record time of 2 hours and 21 minutes despite the heat in Bangkok. So it's not about the heat.
それからもう一つ、時期のお話がありました。これは選手たちは実はこれはあんまり出てないんですけど、選手、チーム、監督は8月に開催していることを MGC は望んでました。
Now also in terms of the timeline and the timing, if you will, of the event, although this has not been made public all that much, the athletes, the coaches and all the members of the team, they had all been indicating that the test event should be, the MGC rather, should be held in August.
で、選手たちは望んでたんですけども、結局その政治的な、許認可の問題等々でやってたので、ここは最終的に日本陸連さんに聞いていただかないと、僕はその9月にやった最終的なジャジメントの材料というのは分かりませんけども、間違いなく選手たちは同じ条件でやりたい、せっかくやって同じ条件でやることが一番いいということを選手たちも言っていたということはお伝えしておきます。
And so the athletes, they wanted to see the event be held in August. However, due to, to various political perhaps dynamics and also because of the various approvals and, approvals that were necessary. And you'll have to ask the members of the Japan Athletics Federation for details. But the event was going to, was held in September. But without a doubt, the athletes, they would have liked to have had an event under the same, same set of conditions.That would have been the most ideal for the athletes.
Yes, please.
どうぞ。
ご苦労様です。デモクラシータイムズの山田と申します。今、選手の発言が出たので、確認のためにお伺いしたいと思います。これだけのテストイベントを重ねてやってきたのに、準備不足で、準備のされてないところで、走るのは不安だと選手は言っていると、あるいは7万人の新国立競技場でゴールするのが、まあ、楽しみだったということを選手が言っていると言いましたが、この選手とはどなたなんでしょうか。それとこれは日本人選手というふうに置き換えると分かりやすいんですが、競技に参加するのは世界各国の選手だと思います。それで東京に慣れている、特に暑さというのは一つのファクターと言いますけれども、大事なファクターだと思うんですが、そういうところで慣れられる日本の選手と世界で、まあ、今わずかの準備期間で来られる方とのギャップ、この、まあ、不平等といっては何でしょうけども、その違いをどのように認識されているでしょうか。選手が日本人選手と、参加されるすべての選手をどうお考えになっているんでしょうか。
My name is Yamada with the Democracy Times. I would like to confirm the following. You did mention that, you mentioned that the athletes have a sense of anxiety about having to run in a place where there's going to be a lack of sufficient preparations, and that they were not able to host a test event, and that these athletes were all looking forward to coming back to the new national stadium packed with 70,000 people. But if we could ask, which particular athlete did you talk to? And also, was it a Japanese? You have to remember that in these events, athletes from all over the world will be coming to take part in the event. And of course, although the heat, you might say, is only one of the factors, I believe heat is a very important factor. The Japanese athletes have the chance to acclimatize themselves to the Tokyo environment, although the athletes from outside Japan, they will have a very short period of time to prepare, which means that there's going to be a gap. I wouldn't say inequality, but there's a gap. And so what are your thoughts about the differences of the potential differences of positions of Japanese athletes and non-Japanese athletes? Thank you.
質問ありがとうございます。 最初に、申し上げますと、わざと僕が名前を出してないのは、名前を出せない理由があるということだけまずお含みください。
Thank you for your question. The reason why I did not cite any particular names, we hope you will understand that there is a reason, there's a backdrop as to why I simply am not in a position to share that name with you. I would appreciate your understanding.
ただ間違いなく MGC を走った選手関係者からお聞きをしています。これだけは間違いないです。
But one thing I can say without a doubt is that these views of which I have heard from the circle of athletes and concerned parties involved in the event who took part in the aforementioned MGC。
そしてもう一つご質問いただきました外国選手のことなんですが、外国選手からも突然この変えることに対しての抗議が非常に来ております。このコメントはどこかで我々もまとめて一回出したいなというふうには思っているんですが、かなり要するに直前に変えることへの抗議ということがたくさん来ております。
And also as for athletes outside the Japanese athletes, actually we have received many voices who are protesting the fact that this sudden change was made. So hopefully at some time going forward we'll be able to compile these views and be able to share that in one way or another. But yes, these we have received very strong voice of opposition in terms of the sudden change.
もちろん暑さ、暑い方がよりも涼しい方が記録は出ますけども、選手たちが一番言ってるのは、暑いのも一つの条件、風が強い、暑い、寒い、いろんな条件があります。これはアウトドアスポーツではつきものです。
And also, of course, in terms of the heat, it is likely that a better record will probably be viable in a colder weather compared against the heat. However, many of the athletes said that if heat is one of the conditions that they have to address, and also in an outdoor event, there are various conditions the athletes have to accommodate, be it strong wind, hot weather or cold weather.
つまり先ほども少しお話ししましたが、その条件が早くからちゃんと開示をされていて、平等に準備する期間があることが大事なことであって、直前に条件を変えることがフェアじゃないんじゃないかというのは、これは海外の選手からも来ております。
So the important thing is that sufficient time be provided to all so that they will have sufficient time to prepare under the same set of conditions. And the voice from the non-Japanese athletes were that to have the sudden change in these conditions does not seem very fair.
お答えになったでしょうか?
I hope I've been able to respond to your question.
Okay, thank you. I saw another question here.
どうぞ。
ワシントンポストの柏木と思います。今日はありがとうございます。暑さは一つのリスクとおっしゃられたので、もう一度繰り返しですけれども、やはりこれが一番 IOC の懸念だと思いますので、このリスクはやはり取る価値はあるといいますか、そういうお考えでしょうか。それから5時に開始も考えられるというご提案はどれほど実現のあるご提案でしょうか。
Kashiwagi from Washington Post. You mentioned that the heat is one of the risks, but of course it is a very significant risk. So at the risk of repeating myself, do you believe that this heat, the risk of heat, it is a risk worth taking, considering that it is a very significant a risk? Is it a risk worth taking? And also you talked about the potential for moving the starting time up to 5 a.m. How feasible do you think that this proposal is? Thank you.
はい、じゃあ私は簡単に、ね、はい、ご質問ありがとうございます。こちらもですね、先ほどの私どもの資料の3ページにあるんですけれども、まあ、例えば5時スタートであればですね、ドーハのマラソンの状況とは大きく異なってくるというのがまずポイントとして言って、そして札幌の7時スタートも、これも我々は仮に置いただけなんですけれども、それと比べた場合においてもですね、大きなそこまでですね、際立ったリスクというところまで評価できないではないか、同程度のリスクの場合も当然ございます、札幌でも。ですので、それが大変重要なリスク、重要なファクターであることは私どもそう理解しておりますけれども、その点においてですね、大変際立っていると、例えば早朝スタートであればそのようには理解はしておりません。
Thank you for your question. If you could please turn to page, again, if you can turn to page three of the material. If we are able to change the starting time to 5 a.m., then we believe that the situation will be totally different from the situation which one, from the one which we observed in Doha. And also, again, if we're simply assuming hypothetically that the starting time is up or will be 7 o'clock on this particular chart, again, there is no, again, there is no major difference against the scenario as well. And so therefore, it cannot be said that we recognize a very significant, grave, sufficient risk, if you will. We believe that the conditions will be probably on par with that in Sapporo. So yes, we do recognize and understand that the heat is a very important factor, but we do not believe that it, at this moment, it represents an overly excessive risk at this juncture.
そして今6時からまあ5時に早めるということなんですけれども、まあ、5時でよく言われるのがですね、まあ、暗いのではないかとですね、まず言われます。それについては我々の資料のまあ5ページこちらはですね、あの写真なんですけれども、十分ですね、あの左の写真は電気がついていない状態、そして右の写真は電気がついている状態なんですけれども、まあ、周りの方のご協力いただきながらですね、ライトアップしていくということであれば、走るアスリートの皆様にとってはですね、あの特に支障はないかなと思っています。
And also, in terms of changing of the time, the starting time from 6 a.m. to 5 a.m., some people point to the fact that it might be dark in 5 a.m. If you take a look at the picture on page 5 of the material, on the left-hand side shows the picture where there is no lighting at 5 a.m., and the right-hand side picture shows you a situation where there is lighting provided. So if we're able to solicit the cooperation from the people in the community,and could provide lighting, if you will, then we believe that this should not present any obstacles, if you will, for the athletes.
5時のスタートに対する、まあ、信憑性というか実現性みたいなお話だったと思いますけども、あの東京都としてはまだ最終確認ではありませんが、それほどハードルは高くないというふうに考えています。まあ、それ以上に、おそらく IOC の資料を先ほどお配りしましたが、 IOC の資料の中で早朝ではダメな理由というのが IOC から示されていますので、そこを読んでいただくと分かると思います。
And also in terms of the feasibility, if you will, how feasible is the 5 a.m. start scenario? Again, this is not an official final proposal from the TMG, but we believe that the Tokyo Metropolitan Government does not feel that this represents a very difficult obstacle, if you will. And also, we provided you with the materials which the IOC has provided, and in that page, you will understand, you will find a page that describes why IOC.Believes that this starting time will not work. If you take a look at their reasoning, I think this situation will become very clear.
あのページで言うと、この赤い、あ、ごめんなさい、カラーでない方もいらっしゃるので、若干分かりづらいと思いますけど、ここにあの Why promoting earlier start times という項目で出ているページです。
So some of you do not have colored copies. Our apologies, but the page should have the title of Why promoting earlier start times would not work.
ここを読んでいただくと分かりますけども、IOC からの見解は真っ暗、あの夜中だと人がいないとか、ヘリコプターが飛ばないとか、あまり我々からすると現実的ではないというか、なんかクリアできるんじゃないかなというような問題点の指摘になっているところがありますけども、まあ、これはあの取る方でいろいろ違うと思いますけど、そんな皆さんも読んでいただくとお分かりになると思います。
And on this page, they'll go on to describe the fact that if it's 5 a.m., it's simply too dark, people will not be outside, and that there is, and the helicopter simply cannot fly at this very dark, in such a dark environment. But from where we sit, we believe that these are probably reasons or issues which can be overcome. I suppose it is a matter of how one perceives these issues, but I think if you take a look at this page, you will understand.
それですいません、もう一つだけ、今その中に、まあ、こういう、もしこの大会で何かあったら、大会と主催者の問題になるというようなことも書かれているんですが、それを言うと、さっきから言うように、われわれが一番問題になるのは、直前に条件を変えること、これが一番良くないんじゃないか、これこそが、主催者の中での問題になるんではないかというふうに考えてますので、そこが一番大きなポイントではないかなというふうに思います。
And also, the one final point which I wish to share. The IOC goes to point out that should something happen during those events, that this would have a very negative impact on the hosts as well as on the games itself, on the game itself. But as far as we're concerned, we believe that the worst matter, if you will, is to suddenly change these conditions immediately before the games. We believe that that represents the most significant problem, and that should be recognized as an issue.
Okay, thank you. With that, we are out of time. I think this controversy will continue. I hope we can get the IOC to come to this club and answer some questions. I think they're the people who we really need to hear from now. But I'd like to thank our guests today, Mr. Hiroshi Yamada, Mr. Taro Shirato, for sparing their time to come and talk about this. And we'll look forward to following events as they develop. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.